the Leviathan, the Western political philosophy, the social contract. These are the many things that define Thomas Hobbes, the English philosopher. But for a more in-depth look at the man himself, we go to our correspondent, Alexander the Great.
Thank you, Charles. So, the great Thomas Hobbes, it's a privilege to meet you.
I must say it's a pleasure to meet you too, Alexander the Great. I must say you are quite a bit smaller than I imagined.
Yes, indeed. Most people say that about me. Now, I've got a couple of questions for you.
Well, fire away, don't hold back. I would love to answer the questions for you.
What are your opinions about a functioning government?
I believe that the people should give up their freedom to a powerful leader. Someone who will have total power to keep citizens under control.
That's very interesting. Care to explain?
Well, I believe that people are deep down evil, that they are born evil. And that when given the opportunity, they will choose the option that is in their best interest. Not what would be necessarily good for the rest of the community. That is why we need a strong leader to tell people what to do, what would be good for the rest of the community.
Wouldn't the king use the people for his own best interest?
I'm going to have to disagree with you on that one.
In your book, The Leviathan, what was the central message that you were trying to portray?
My central message in writing The Leviathan was that a strong central government authority is necessary to avoid discord and civil war.
I'm not sure I know what you mean. Would you care to explain further?
Well, if a ruler asserts himself and shows that he has zero tolerance for disobedience, then his people are going to listen to him and respect his authority. Exactly.
Do you feel that your views have much of an influence on today's society?
Yes, I see that your countries have actually taken a page from my playbook by not allowing people to fully govern themselves. Your country is too lax for my taste, but it's something, right?
What evidence exactly do you have that supports that people are truly evil?
Well, there are wars over oil and greed of resources, and people would rather kill someone than get in trouble for a law that they have broken. Exactly. My point exactly. That was a little child saying he would rather kill his friend and cover it up than get in trouble for breaking his parents' rules. People are definitely evil.
Later on in your life, you adapted a new idea known as Hobbism. What was the main message or idea behind Hobbism?
Well, it was my idea that it is the responsibility of every lover of morality and religion to denounce themselves.
Would you care to explain further about what you just said?
Well, anyone with morals should be able to admit that they're naturally evil. Otherwise, they don't have morals.
He's eating my hair.
Then people will listen to him and respect his authority.
Dang it!
Dang it, I didn't respect my authority. Well, if a ruler asserts himself...
I was like...
recording?
Yes.
Okay, good. No, let me go. Well, as you see, I would not have it. God. Oh, you confused me. Well, there are wars over oil and greed, and people would rather kill someone than get out of my lap, Squish.
You should have kept going.
I'm sorry, but he's...